A new bridge, wholly funded by China, is formally opened in Manila. President Duterte led the inauguration of the four-lane bridge that links Chinatown to the walled city of Intramuros. Duterte thanked China for enhancing infrastructure projects in the Philippines. He again insists that the Philippines does not have a quarrel with China, despite China's aggressive moves in the West Philippine Sea.
Ambassador Wang, the Philippines and China, we do not have any quarrel. And we can talk about the Spratly Islands and probably the fishing rights of my countrymen plain talk, nothing else.
Duterte and Chinese President Xi Jinping are set to hold a virtual meeting on Friday.
Manila's defense chief insists the Chinese ship that entered Philippine waters from January 29 to February 1 was meant to closely monitor the joint naval exercises of the Philippines and the U.S. at that time. Secretary Delfin Lorenzana says while he does not find the incident disturbing, the act of shadowing the drills does contradict Beijing's claim of innocent passage. The Department of Foreign Affairs last month summoned China's ambassador to the Philippines over the presence of that Chinese Navy ship in the Sulu Sea without the government's permission.
President Rodrigo Duterte rejects proposals to put some areas under the so-called COVID alert level zero. Duterte says alert level one should stay in place amid the threat of new COVID-19 variants.
Lahat gusto halos balik na sa zero. O lahat one. That hindi pwede kasi may mga lugar na meron pa. Until such time na talagang almost isa-dalawa na lang all over the country, yung alert one would still be a good parang buffer natin. Huwag na muna tanggalin natin yan until we are very sure that everything is really all right.
Near 200 areas in the Philippines, including Metro Manila, are currently under alert level one. The Philippine Labor Department will decide on the wage hike petitions for Metro Manila workers in May. The agency says consultations and public hearings will be held before DOLE deliberates on the matter.
May board resolution po kasi kami. We passed that last week, yung tatlong petitions po. Yun po yung binigyan namin ng due course. Dahil pumasa naman po ito sa aming rules and regulations. Tatlo po itong petitioners at ang kanilang prayer doon sa kanilang petition ay 213 increase to the current minimum wage po na 537. We will give due course pa rin po doon sa 470. Iko-consolidate lang natin. So, bale ang range ngayon ng petition, yung kanilang wage increase is from 213 to 470.
The wage board earlier junked the 470 peso minimum wage hike petition for Metro Manila workers filed by the Trade Union Congress of the Philippines. The TUCP has since refiled a tweaked version of its petition.
Philippine economic managers highlight the achievements of the Duterte administration months before the president ends his term. As Jackie Pascual tells us, they remain optimistic on the growth prospects of the country despite lingering uncertainties.
7 to 9%, that remains to be the Philippine economic manager's growth forecast for the country this year, despite uncertainties from the Russia-Ukraine conflict and the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. At the Philippine economic briefing, several cabinet officials highlighted the gains of the Duterte administration, from infrastructure to social services and fiscal economic reforms.
As the pandemic subsides, the Philippine economy is now well on its way to rapid recovery. Our risk management strategy culminated in a full year growth of 5.6% in 2021, exceeding target and market expectations. This year, we expect our economy to grow by 7 to 9%. COVID-19 cases are subsiding rapidly, while our vaccination program is proceeding apace. Last year, our revenue collection was already 5% higher than in 2020, signaling a return to robust economic activity.
Dominguez adds, the government marked its final full year with an all-time high record of foreign direct investments amounting to $10.5 billion, and trade and remittances have returned to pre-pandemic levels. But it's not totally smooth sailing. The finance chief says they continue to monitor developments in Ukraine as this may further push up prices of basic goods and fuel. Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno adds they are ready to take appropriate monetary actions if conditions require it.
At our latest policy meeting, our assessment was that keeping the policy rate at this level was appropriate, given increased uncertainty surrounding the outlook for both inflation and growth. However, recent data, including the latest inflation number, this marks, what is it, four, right? Suggests that inflation is likely to remain elevated in the coming months. So this means that the BSP must be prepared to take action to prevent price pressures from broadening and becoming more entrenched, which could translate to second-round effects.
The National Economic and Development Authority is also monitoring another possible casualty of the crisis in Ukraine.
With respect to the Russia-Ukraine crisis, we think that what will be affected will be on airline travel. With respect to the resumption of travel, then that could be affected.
The officials, however, are optimistic of reaching high growth for this year, with improvements in the agriculture sector, trade, tourism, as the country further eases restrictions, opening up the economy even more.
January of 2021, only last year, and the January of 2022 this year, there's already an incremental 3.5 million new employment recorded. Of course, there will be more as we expect all these investments to come in after all these major economic reforms and liberalization.
A 7-9% economic growth is achievable, they say, as NEDA reveals it has graded the country's COVID-19 recovery scorecard to almost a perfect score. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.